fall, I told him to go down on his knees, and he was in the middle. I told him that a day will come where the inside will not contain the people again. And I came here to fulfill that prophecy. I've seen it in my right eyes happen. God is gracious and kind. Look at what God is doing. Look at what God is doing. I came to worship God for the exploit around this place. Before I minister this song, I'm a poet, but I did not know what led me to do a song. Let me give the testimony before I minister the song. My roommate in the University of Port Harcourt had a growth in his body. So they took him for surgery, UPTH. He lost his mom and he lost his younger sister. So it's only him and his dad that were together. So I called his dad. The dad said, in his place of work, they will not release him. I was the one that signed the consent form. When I was done, they took him in. When they were doing the surgery, some people came out and they were crying. They just lost someone inside. I was like, God, this guy cannot die. His mom is late, his sister is late, he can't die. I can't stand on behalf of this guy and he died. God is a shame, but I trust in your name. But at the end of the day, he came out successfully. When I went to the studio, pardon me, when I went to the studio and I went to my friend's studio, when I was just there, one or two was happening, the thoughts that came to my mind was, Akachukudia, Akangozi dia, Akangozi, if you're ready, don't just sit down and let's just do this thing.
I don't know.
Let it come from your heart. I'm beyond a musician. I tell myself always, I'm beyond a poet. I'm a vessel that God used to honor people. Let's be on our knees for this one. If you're ready, I'm ready.
They are
ready.
Oh, dear.
It's not my fault. The best is saying you want to die.
Yeah.